Spaghetti, pomodoro sauce, meatballs. Very simple, everybody loves it. Tomato sauce, which you saw me make in an earlier recipe. The water's boiling with a bit of olive oil in there. Vegetable stock pot in there. And we're gonna shallow fry the meatballs in olive oil. So, as you can see, there's our mince. 500 grams of mince, one egg, one slice of bread, soaked in milk. Squeeze the milk out. What the bread does is make them lighter. Otherwise it's gonna be too heavy. That goes there. And about two cloves of crushed garlic. And we'll season with aromat, which I think is better than salt, but that's just my opinion. And you'll know when it's ready, because it comes together like a paste. You can feel it. Mix everything in well. So I'm just pounding it in. You could put parsley in if you wish to, but don't think it's necessary. So you can see the meat has now come together. All the ingredients have been mixed in well. So now, some flour. Make meatballs about so large. You can make them smaller, you can make them bigger. So you make them as big as you wish. It's always advisable to make your meatball mix a few hours in advance. Just gives time for it to set and for the garlic to infuse. Meatballs, you know, children love them. It's a way of getting children to eat beef when they're very young. So 500 grams of mince would make about 24 meatballs that size. Just flour and reshape the meatballs. And just get off the excess flour. Just cut them in your hand and just reshape them. Okay. We'll flavour our sauce with some basil. If you don't want to use meatballs, you could always do tomato sauce with basil and mozzarella, which is called sorrentina, which is a nice vegetarian dish. Okay. Pomodoro sauce is a great basic in Italian cooking. So for example, say you were making a lobster spaghetti, your base would be pomodoro sauce. Lobster stock with it, parsley. Say you're gonna do a seafood pasta, it's good to have your base as a tomato sauce. Always very important. Right, now what we do is we cook our meatballs, firstly. We'll cook them until they're brown. They won't be 100% cooked, and then we finish them in the hot tomato sauce, and then at the last bit we throw in the basil before we mix it in with the pasta. So now what we can do is we can put some pasta in. So in the water we've got stock pot, we have olive oil, and we'll cook that now for 10 minutes. A minute less than what's recommended on the packet, because remember, when you take it off and put it into your colander, it's still cooking. By the time you put it into your sauce, it's still cooking. So the 11th minute should be being drained and back into the sauce. My favorite way of eating pasta is al boro, just with butter. I like to taste my pasta, and I think that stock pot does a better job than just seasoning it with salt. But that's my preference. And I've used Knorr stock cubes for years. And what I try to do is coordinate everything. I think that's one of the keys of cooking at home, is to coordinate things. By putting my meatballs in, I know then they're cooking, and I've now got 10, 12 minutes for the pasta, get the tomato sauce up to heat, pick my basil, and so my dish all comes together at the end. So as you can see, now let's pomodoro there. Add the meatballs to the pomodoro to finish off the cooking. So there's our meatballs now. So push that to there. Two minutes away on the pasta. We've got our meatballs in the tomato sauce cooking away. In about a minute and a half, we'll take the pasta off, drain it, throw in the basil, and then everything comes together at the same time. See? So now let's take our basil. So just infuse the pomodoro. Okay, I'm going to drain the pasta, drain off the water. Bit of olive oil. There's our pasta. Now take the meatballs. When you think that was less than what was advertised on the packet. But having said that, I am half Italian. It's not the most difficult dish in the world. Why buy them when you can make them? And then just to finish off at the end, some basil. And there we have it, very simply. Spaghetti, pomodoro sauce with meatballs. And to be quite honest, ever since I was a boy, it's been one of my favourite dinners.